Hi friends, in this video we will see how we can debug the Angular code. Now if we want to debug the Angular code, what we can do is, for example, if you go here and if I try to execute this file, now you will be able to see the JS files. What it is loading is main.js, vendor.js, style.js. These all the files these are loading in the Angular. Now, if I want to debug the code, if I want to debugger or if I want to keep any debugger or anything, how I can keep the debugger is, so you can go to the sources file here. In this sources file, if you go into this main.js, you'll be able to see all the Angular code. So right now we have written only small code only, so it is very easy to find where the code is. But if you are writing big large project or anything, so it is difficult for us to find the code where it is there. So for example, our code is, so here you will be able to see that get color and all those things it is there, right? Now here if I go down here, I will be able to see that users.push and all those things. Now if I want to keep the debugger, if I keep the debugger here, immediately what you will see, it has jumped to TS file. You see here, I tried to keep the debugger here in the main.js, it has jumped to users.component.ts and it is keeping the debugger here. So now if I try to refresh or otherwise if I try to click on add user, immediately the debugger came here. Okay, now so this is how we can keep the debugger. Okay, and also another thing what we can do is, now finding the place where the code is there, our code in this main.js, it will be somewhat a little bit of tedious or difficult to find. Now what we can do is, here you can also go to webpack. Here in this webpack, you can go to webpack here, you'll be able to find the webpack, and in this one you'll be able to find this webpack 3/, you'll be able to see here. Okay, in this you'll be able to see source file, not in this one, or somewhere you'll be able to find, sorry, in the dot folder. Okay, so in the dot folder you'll be able to find the code. So if you go here, you'll be able to find source, and whatever the project structure we are having here, you'll be able to find all the project structure here. Okay, now if I try to go to the app file, and here in this users, and you'll be able to find all the HTML and also the TS file what I have written. So here it has jumped to here in this TS. So whatever the folders you want to find, you can able to find in this webpack /, is there, right? In this webpack folder, you'll be able to find in this dot folder, you'll be able to find all the code, whatever the TS code we have written. So you can keep the debugger point here, and you can debug the code. Okay, in this way we can debug the code using Angular. And common types of errors what we can say is, for example, if you see here, I got an error something like cannot read property. If I try to click on add user, so I am trying to click on add user, so I will remove this debugger. Okay, and I am able to see that cannot read property push of undefined. You will be able to see the error here, and here you will be able to see that the core.js, it is showing core.js. We will be not able to find that file core.js. Why? Because it is a compiled file. And here at the down, you will be able to see that users component dot change user created status, users.component.ts28 line. It is telling users.component.28ts. So you can directly go to the user.component.ts and you will be able to find the 28 line. Most of the time, what it will try, Angular will try to do is, it will try to pinpoint the error directly. Okay, if you're not able to pinpoint that one, so you can go to the debugger and you can do the previous thing. So here, if I try to push this one, here it is unable to push the user's data. So why it is trying to unable to push the data? Why? Because so you need to debug the user's thing. So if you go users, and here users, I have just mentioned that the users, and I have not mentioned any the type of the thing. So here if you see, it is a type of any. So what I can do is, you can directly give this one as an array. So for array only, you will be having the option dot push. Now I can go here, and now I am refreshing this one, and I will try to push this one. Now it is automatically pushed. Okay. So in this way you can find the errors. And another one what we can do is, so we can also have a, in Angular we can also have a extension, Chrome extension. So what is the Chrome extension is AUGURY, Augury. Okay, if you search for Augury, so this is Augury. Okay, so this is the developer tool extension for debugging and profiling Angular application. So you can install this install on Chrome, you can install this on Chrome. So I have already installed this extension. You will be able to find Augury here after installing this one. And here you will be able to see the components. What are all the components present in this one? You will be able to see the components. If I close this one and if I open it again, you will be able to find the, if I go to Augury, okay. Okay, here it is telling you the users component and user component and all those things. It is telling what are the components loaded here. And also you are able to see the Angular version 10.0.11 it is telling. And also if you click in this component, you will be able to see the what are all the properties state it is available here. Okay, you will be able to see what are all the properties here. If so, if I try to change here, the data will be changed. So in this way also you can change. You can, in this way also you can check the values, what are all the values present in the components, so what are all the values and also how the value is changing. So if you want to debug about the value data, so whether the data is updating or not, you can check it here. And also you will be able to see the component hierarchy from where this component is coming, from app component to users component it is there. So like this you can check the thing in the Augury also. So this is the about the how we can debug the Angular code in the browser and also in through the code and also through the Chrome extension. So this is where we can debug the Angular code. So if you have any doubts or any suggestions, please post the comments below to this video. And if you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.